nag-create na siya ng private army, sir. Paano po napunta sa ganitong sitwasyon?
That was my question also. Muna yung akong pangatanan sa iya, pero meron nagkita may gabi o sa iyang asawa. Nga naman, nagpalit mo ng daghang pusil. Kung sama mo, sukol mo sa gobyerno. Nga naman, o karon, doon ay nangamatay. Duha, o gangsa, critically wounded. Kinsa may mutabagaan ng sala. O, di ba? So, sabi ko, you have graduated from scammer or estafador into a murderer. Kasi you are prepared to die with this kind of firearms, but of course with the superior strategy and training of my men. Alam niyo ba yung operation na nangyari? Parang beach landing, parang World War II. Kasi napaka secluded nung lugar, tapos we can only approach from the sea, not from the road. And we have to walk several kilometers under the cover of darkness, gabi, niyabot may buntag na. So, as you can see, even one of these light machine gun na nagamit na sakto, daghan man mga matay na sundalo ko o police o coast guard. So sa ako yung nangutana sa iya, nga naman nag-assemble mo ng mga ingani kadako na kusog ng mga armas o mga tao. O doon na pa yung namatay. Eh, ministro ka ako, di ba? Ministro, you're supposed to be spreading the love, the word of God. Love thy neighbor, ana-ana, ngano man, eh, siya na yung makatubag ninyo.
Yes, sir. In this press conference, hindi po ba pwede si Apolinario matanong, sir? Hindi po.
May right siya eh. Karon, giprocess lang din sila diha. Pero kung bago namin i-transfer sila sa ilang investigation room, kumutubag siya, nasa iyan na to.
Yes, sir. Follow-up ko lang po, sir. Sir, pwede po ba malaman po natin, kunting senaryo lang po, sir, during the raid ng tauhan po natin, ano po senaryo? Nanlaban po sila? May nangyari ba talagang bakbak?
I have my ground commander here, Colonel Roger Quisada, who is my deputy regional director for operation. He was the ground commander. Ang spearhead ay itong si Colonel Gil Toralba. Of course, ang ating yun sa tropa, si Captain Edward Cantano, and the Coast Guard. Ito talaga malaki pagod, ano? Ano ba rago mo, Commander? Ensign Nieto, anong first name? Christian. Of course, kilala nyo, itong ating RMG, si Olyaging. Siya ang dusap complement ng RMFB. And of course, hindi matatawaran ang ating sub-commander. Nandun din sila. At laki hirap niyan. Can you introduce your team leaders, Chris?
Sir, I'm Police Lieutenant Colonel Christopher Mendoza, the Battalion Commander of the 1st Special Action Battalion of the PNP Special Action Force. With me during the operation is my deputy, Police Major Ernesto Atiga Jr., my company commander of the 11th Special Action Company, Police Captain Jomar Kilang. My company commander of the 14th Special Action Company, Police Major Tan Bulaglag. My company commander of the 15th Special Action Company, Police Major Jing Alarcon. And my two lieutenants, Lieutenant Obiena and Lieutenant Isip. We are all together during the operation together with the RMFB, with the Coast Guard, with the ARSOG, and the other operatives of the Police Regional Office 13.
Of course, ang ating command group sa support, ang head natin dyan, ang ating DRDA, Police Brigadier General Jimmy Limacaraeg, ang dakilang abala, ang ating PCRS, Colonel Jerry Portacio. Now, I will give you on what is the operational condition during the implementation of the warrant of arrest and the search warrant. Andito ang ating DRDO, Colonel Roger Quisada.
Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat. Ano? Itong operation na to ay talagang combined effort po to ng ating PNP, ng of course yung SAP, Coast Guard, and then with the support of the Philippine Army, ano. So yung lugar talagang napaka-secluded, malayo. So we have to use sea vessels. Transport po yung sa proper natin from Bisleg going to Lingig. Travel time about more or less 4 hours. So during that the whole night nagtatravel yung tropa, then the approach umapros na by Beachland and the other group of Colonel Olaging inapros namin dito sa harapan sa main gate. So sabay po yan na pumasok, and unfortunately lumaban po yung nasa yung tao niya dito sa by beach landing zone. So doon po nagkaroon ng bakbakan. So dalawang tao yung yes sir. Anyway,
thank you so much sir.
Of course sila hindi naman magpapaputok yung tropa natin kung wala silang walang putok na nagagalit sa kalaban.
Next question, Joy Di Kamutan.
Magandang araw po sa lahat ng mga ating mga magigiting na mga PNP. Sir, sa ginagawa niyong initial investigation, paano nila natupuslit itong mga sangkatutak na baril at saan nila na itong nabili?
That is the subject of our investigation. As you can see, in the first place, it was only an information. So we have verified and by several sources from within and without that there exists a group of people roaming around and believed to be CAPA members. That was the only report, CAPA members. So it went to the process of validation. So after that, we have executed. Talagang it's a long, long procedure of surveillance and the processing of information. We have to recruit our assets and of course ang tulong ng ating NICA on the IT side of the signal intelligence, hindi matatawaran. So it resulted and of course the planning and the execution talagang maingat na pinagplanuhan to, dahil kaya nga walang casualty dun sa atin. At minimal din ang casualty sa kanila kasi madali ding sila nga nasubdue. Otherwise nga, sabi ko sa inyo, kung nakaputok ng todo itong lahat-lahat ng firearms na to, eh maraming mamamatay. So that is the testament to the level of professionalism ng ating mga tropa dito sa Caraga. Not only the PNP but to include our brothers in the Coast Guard and in the Armed Forces. Kaya meron tayong na-accomplish na ganitong kalaki.
Sana po malaman namin sa takbo ng investigation nyo, dahil para yung taong bayan hindi magduda, baka tako mayroong involved dito mga government nasa government site na nagbenta ng baril.
Yes, that would be part definitely of our investigation. So far, the main part here is the implementation of warrant of arrest and the implementation of the search warrant leading to a positive result. That is our primary investigation. But I have, as the chief have instructed, I'm already creating a special investigation task group to be led by the DRDO as the special task group commander. So we will invite the CIDG, the crime lab, the intelligence community to get to the bottom of things and to provide assistance to other complainant who may have right to claim their money. On how to go about it, I'm designating again Police Colonel Roger Quesada as the Special Investigation Task Group Apolinario, CAPA, so that all complaints pertaining to the activity of the said group, both the international and the one that was created here in Bisleg and Jensen, General Santos City, and will be addressed. So later on, we will come up with a hotline so that our people can talk to them and schedule whatever legal assistance or initial police action that we can provide, because as I've said, this group of Apolinario have victimized really quite a number of people here in Mindanao, and some of the investors are from even from Visayas and Manila. So duly noted, and we will do this.
One last question, sir. Apolinario is facing a syndicated Stapa. What about his private army? What is
that is bukod dun sa iyang warrant of arrest, no bail sa syndicated Stapa, tapos sa illegal possession of firearms of an explosive, he will be also charged with direct assault and illegal association. And we are also looking into if there is additional case, because people died. These people who died must be attributed to somebody, and since he gave the order to amass these firearms and fire upon the law enforcer, he is liable.
Thank you, sir. Next is from Love Radio, Martin D. Bernard Panisalis.
Yes, sir, from Net TV and Love Radio. My question is, there are some informations nga nakuha namin, no, sa online, that wala raw nangyari na ano, wala raw nangyaring bakbakan at may negotiation daw. At sabi pa niya na hindi totoo na inaristo, but sumurrender daw. So, can you clarify on this mga lumalabas na ganitong klaseng information?
Sino ba yung source mo? Pwede ko bang kuna ng statement yan?
Yeah, mga yung mga ano lang, I don't know kung mga supporters sila.
Siyempre, as a reporter, you're responsible.
Yes, sir.
Before you put up any issue, you have checked.
Yes, sir.
Your resources.
Meron ho kami, sir.
Sino? Kukuha na ko ng statement. If that allegation is true, we will investigate it. But as I've said, the moment na nakita yung tropa natin, we were fired upon. And but they surrender later on. Talaga okay. Naman yung iba nakakita lang ng picture sabihin sumurrender na
Yeah, tama.
So if there is a truth to what he is alleging, come forward and stand by your word. I will investigate, sign for it. That's the problem with fake news.
Okay,
so wag tayong basta-basta naniniwala na may sinabing ganon. Wala naman sa area nakakita ng isa dalawang picture na conclude niya na. Okay. Na hindi lumaban, was he there?
Okay.
If that person were there, he is a reliable. Oh. Ito na mismo, sila natanongin mo dyan Sila mismo bakit ka naman lumaban? Talagang lalaban ako. So, yan ang sinasabi natin. Let us be responsible of entertaining fake news. That is a fake news. Sir, lumaban Nakita mo ba yung power na yan? Pagka ba humawak ka niyan, ang ibig sabihin niyan, hindi ka lalaban? This is the mere possession of this firearm is your arm to the teeth, and wala nang makakapagsabi na hindi lalaban ito. Di sana toothpick ang hawak nila, hindi lumaban. So, I suggest people to be responsible. May nakita lang kayong picture, isa dalawang picture dyan kung ano na ang pinagsasabi nyo. Nakita nyo itong firearms na to? Alam ka naman nilaglag ng pulis to. O, pag ganitong karaming firearms, wala ka ba intention lumaban? So, that's my answer to that. And he, if he is true to this word, take a number of this media. I would like to take the statement of that person alleging that ganyan. I will investigate that. I do not tolerate execution style operation. So, I will investigate. Take the number and we will get the statement.
All right, sir.
Go ahead.
Second question, sir, is about sa itong nag-complain. Do we have... complainants here in...
Pakilapit lang yung bibig mo sa mic.
Yung ano, yung complainant.
Speak properly.
Yung complainant po.
Yung complainant?
Yes.
What about the complainant?
Do we have complainants here in...
Ang complainant nga, Filipino, people of the Philippines, kasi illegal possession of firearms and ammunition and explosives. So, dyan, no bail na sila dyan sa explosive. So, he will be investigated to that. If you're referring to the complainant of the Ponzi scheme, as I've said earlier, we are creating a special intelligence task group. We will assist them so that kung ano yung kaso nilang i-file para makuha nila yung kwarta na nakamkam nitong Apolinario et al. We will assist them. Kasi for now, yung criminal case yung amin, implementation of the warrant of arrest for syndicated Stapa and illegal possession of firearms and explosive. No bail na yon, yung explosive. Plus, direct assault kasi lumaban sila sa police. Plus, illegal association. O, dahil this is a private army. Private armed group na to. So, he will be answerable to that inasmuch as sa Karaga 13 is concerned. As to the complaint, the Ponzi scheme, we will assist in the investigation as have ordered by our chief of the Philippine National Police. We will assist the complainant. Kay naluoy man me, kay mga daghang mga dreams ang nawala dahil dito sa mga kalokohan ito na ginagamit ang Ginoo para makapangloko ng tao, ministry. Dapat nag-i-spread ng love yan, hindi nag-i-spread ng panluloko. Sabi ko nga sa kanya, hindi ka na lang istapador ngayon ano ka pa papatay ka pa ng tao. Ano sa man? Next question.
Final question, sir. Kailan daw yung ibang mga scheme, investment scheme, kailan daw ang operation para sa kanila? O ongoing na ba kayo?
Teka, ito yung press conference natin. Ano ba yung tinatanong mong iba? Ito yung press conference natin, Kappa Group. Can you clarify your question? Sino pang grupo yung sinasabi mo?
Yung... meron kasi may mga forex at iba pang mga investment scheme.
Hindi yun yung press briefing na to. Yung press briefing na to is a Kappa International. Anyway, anybody who violates the law, rest assured that the Karaga Police will go after them. Even if they possess tank, anti-tank, we have their rocket-propelled grenade. Buti hindi na iputok sa mga bata ko. Alam niyo ba yung rocket-propelled grenade? Anti-tank yan. But I'd like to clarify, this is a press conference for the rest of Joel Abuntonon Apolinario Kappa Ministry. All other similar scheme happening in Karaga, we will go against them. We are open for any complainant. I believe there are some already operating in other parts of Karaga and there are other monitoring.
Okay, but
Thank you, Martin. Next is Clyde Hikilan of Hope Radio.
I mean, buntag sa tanan, RD. Actually, sorry karon pag nakaabot. Ako lang ipanguta na RD ha. Since na may giorganize nila nga since may inorganisa sila na grupo armado pa. Since effective na yung anti-terror law, pwede ba silang makasuhan ng in related sa anti-terror law natin?
The new anti-terrorist bill is for publication. Awaiting the implementing rules and IRR regulation. But per se, it is an approved law. We will look into it if this particular anti-terrorist act already, not ATB, it's already an act, it's a law that has been passed, if they have violated the anti-terrorist act. We will look into it.
Follow up? Next is Julius Lacerda of Brigada News FM. Julius? Wala na yung mangutana? Oh, Aisa Supas from Radyo Trompeta.
Sir, dagdag ko lang na tanong, sir. Yung sinasabi ni PNP Chief kanina na $900,000 or $50 billion, ano po yun, sir? Pera po ba yun ng Kappa? At nasaan na po ngayon yun, sir? At ano pong disposition ni Apolinario right after this, sir?
These are fact already in situational, called from previous events. Anyway, we will be distributing press release. These details are on that press release. So, that happened long time ago and it was established fact na parang na-check siya doon. Ito yung pera niya. These are background there, situational. However, we will giving a press release copy to the media.
Okay, lastly, sir. Possibly ba, sir, na from terrorist group ang mga armas or the Anti-Terrorism Council will be declared them as terrorist groups, sir, since they are possessing this kind of high-powered firearms, sir?
Yeah, that's why I said we will look into it kasi this Anti-Terrorist Act is relatively new, kaya nga meron dyan tinatawag na designation, ide-designate ka na, tapos under surveillance ka. Pag na-prove na you are conducting terroristic act, then you'll be arrested for 14 days, extendable to 10 days. But we will check if they have violated the Anti-Terrorist Act. But at this juncture, I'd like to remind that the chief has promised to give awards And I'd like you to give my DRDA, who is in charge of the SPAD B, ano ba gagawin natin yan para mabigyan ng appropriate award.
Thank you. Julius Lacerda of Brigada News. Okay. Excuse me, Julius. DRDA, sir.
Good morning sa lahat. For the benefit of ng lahat, ang proseso, we will include kung posible yung special promotion for those who are involved, and yung pinakamataas na pwede natin ibigay, and re-recommend natin kagad sa Chief Philippine National Police as instructed. So starting tomorrow ay i-account na namin kung sino yung mga involved na ating mga kapulisan. So as the chairman of the special promotions board ng PRO 13 ay magkukonvene kami kagad para maibigay yung kaukulang award at saka promotion sa lahat ng mga involved.
Thank you. Going back to your question, ano yung last question? Yes, meron pa?
Julius of Brigada News.
Yes sir, magandang umaga. Sir, sa ngayon, ano pong disposisyon ni Pastor Joel, kasi nalaman natin na yung warrant of arrest niya galing sa Cagayan de Oro, at saka magkasama sir, anong disposisyon ngayon?
Arestado nga siya, yung inisyo yung warrant of arrest for syndicated stapa. Bakit? Pero meron siyang bagong kaso. Ito, illegal possession of firearms and explosive by virtue of the search warrant. So, aasuntin siya ron, and the appropriate time, we will return the warrant also to the issuing judge of Cagayan de Oro. So, sino ang judge yan? By 11th, Judicial Region Branch. Yun sa warrant, search warrant. Anyway, we will return the warrant of arrest. No bail naman siya doon. Eh, dito sa implementation of search warrant, no bail din siya rito because of the explosive.
Sir, as a procedure, napailalim na ba sila sa rapid test?
Ha?
Napasa ilalim na ba ito sa rapid test, itong mga nahuli?
O, i-check din natin yan. Kaya nga, ini-implementa natin yung social distancing. Hindi lang yun. Para pintest ko pa rin yan para malaman kung sino talaga sa kanila yung nagpaputok. Thank you. O yung, ano sa, ano, kumukulong wax yung kamay mo para malaman kung ano ka, kung nagpaputok ka ng baray.
Yes, Raymond Octobre, UNTV.
Sir, may iba pa po bang mansion or hideout or rest house itong si Apolinario sir na tinitignan po natin, at baka may mga armas pa po doon sir na mga nakatago pa?
Ano daw? Marami yun yung pinunta naming hideout. Tatlo yun. Tapos yung dalawa sub-target, tatlo. Napakalaki. So kung meron pang, ewan ko kung may iba pang Joel Apolinario, pero yung main target natin, si Joel Apolinario, nahuli na natin. As to kung meron siyang other safe house, marami yun. Ang laki nung area. So as much as that safe house is concerned, na-search na natin.